I want to start this video off with a quote by Eminem, and he said, "I say what I want to say and do what I want to do. There's no in between. People will either love you for it or hate you for it."
Complex ambition.
They gonna love me for my ambition.
This is this week's paid promoter snippet.
We got big plates, big meetings, big stakes. Ain't no mistakes, no missteps, just wrist takes. I wonder how much weight my wrist takes. Cause my rollie looking nice, but this Patek look gray. Needle in a haystack, I'm rare. Ride my tractor with a beer. Haters ain't gonna never think it's fair.
Like what you heard, be sure to click down below in the description. And also feel free to email us at complexambition401@gmail.com.
Shout out to everybody out there in the world. You guys could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with us again this week, and we appreciate you guys per usual. Complex Ambition. Sound!
My name is YI.
And we already know what we're going to get in the comments. There's going to be 100 million kids, or maybe grown men.
Maybe grown men.
Maybe older than Eminem.
Stop. Sorry.
Listen, saying, damn, you guys skipped that bar on track 3. Damn.
That shit right went over your head.
It went over your head. Damn, but 12 is one of the best records I heard in my life.
Damn, this is one of his best albums. It's not even an album, it's a deluxe.
Listen.
Damn, you guys are haters. I didn't even watch the video yet, and you guys are hating.
Yeah, you guys watched it already with preconceived notions. I want all the Eminem fans, if you guys are just gonna be who you are, this might not be the video for
this
you.
This might not be the video
but for you. But who knows?
But listen, we always knows? Say this. We always say this. I want to just make this shit clear.
We come in it unbiasedly. We try our best. I can swallow a bottle of alcohol in a... We try our best.
His old shit, man, listen.
We said that this was one of his best albums. We said it in a while.
His best album. Listen, I'm coming from a real place. I had Eminem posters on my motherfucking wall in my bedroom when I was a kid. I was in fourth grade idolizing this guy. You know what I'm saying? The reality is that Eminem has made a huge impact on me, and I still consider him top 5 rappers of all time. But does that mean I have to, everything he drops, I have to kiss his ass? Oh my God! This is your best shit, bro!
No.
Get the fuck out of here.
People
he hasn't dropped consistently great music.
In a while.
And if you don't see that, it's because you probably only listen to him. That's the only hip hop artist you probably listen to.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you look at the hip hop scene, and I'm not saying he has to be part of the hip hop scene in terms of being with the young kids and doing what they're doing, but even if you look at the older OGs, right? Eminem is like stepping outside of that. He's not even part of that conversation right now.
Yeah.
Because he's been dropping the ball.
Realistically.
He still sells like crazy.
He still sells. He still has the millions, maybe billions.
Yeah.
He's always going to be Mr. Classics, right?
Always.
So, you know, if you have a classic discography, maybe the newer releases can't really taint it. But, man, I don't know. He keeps just dropping music. I think obviously he's addicted to rapping. He did say that with Sway. He's like, oh, I just love rapping,
man,
you know.
It's beautiful, man. It's his form of expression.
It's beautiful to see. But we're going to critique the music because we're going to critique it. At the end of the day, people have to be honest. Is it good? Is it not good? And that's it. You know, it's that simple. It's nothing personal.
Yeah.
You motherfuckers want to make it personal in the comments, go right ahead and always do it. I really don't care, but we're going to keep consistently reacting to it because it is Eminem.
If we do it with the young kids, why can't we do it with the older folks, man?
Exactly.
At the end of the day, you know, we're really on the pulse of the culture.
And a lot of motherfuckers, let's be honest, who react to his music and be like, oh, every bar they break down and like, oh. They do it because it's not really genuine. They know that it's going
to
get the views and this and that. We're not going to suffice to that. We're going to be authentic to ourselves. There's that bar and then this and that.
Oh my God, the label paid me. I got to react to your shit and act like I literally really like it.
Yeah.
We're not.
There's a lot of
mules.
Fake motherfuckers out there. But salute to them, I guess, you know, congratulations. We're going to keep it authentic always. This is 16 new songs. The intro again is where the outro ended with Alfred. Alfred, known as the Butler, and Batman, but that's not the Alfred motherfuckers. It's actually Alfred Hitchcock.
Yeah.
I like the thematic of it. Mm-hmm. Very random. Wow. We wish it was like around Halloween or something, but hey, it works. And now we have him again dropping it. Christmas time, I guess, right in time. I don't know, man. Listen, he wasn't touring this year, so this is gonna, you know, keep him more relevant, help him money wise. He probably doesn't need help, but you know what the fuck I mean.
Thus far, this album has provided music to be buried by.
Skylar Gray.
I love Skylar Gray.
Classic Eminem collaborator from the top, Black Magic.
We're violent. I can't call it though. I'm too small a hoe, but none of these hoes can fuck with my girl. She got that. Wake up to music to be murdered by like.
Next song.
Before I check the mic, would be coronavirus in effect tonight. Antiseptics on deck, I got every type. I'm throwing my tux to the tag and watch stop. But always get attacked.
Yeah. This nigga's making music just exclusively for critics.
Yeah. Because from the beginning of the verse, talking about, you know, he makes money still off his garbage, which we know. You know, he's like, I drop garbage, but I still...
He's saying I drop trash, but I still get the bag when I throw garbage...
Some shit.
When I'm throwing garbage out.
Yeah, it's like...
a bar. It's a good-ass bar.
It's like, nigga,
but
we get it. We say that. But it's like, are you acknowledging you're dropping trash then? I don't know.
I don't know.
But then also, what did he say here? Something about the critics... Listen, man, I don't know.
A lot of money talk so far.
A lot of money talk, bragging. Account. He has a lot of bars. Let's not lie.
Where? He's always going to have
He's always going to have the bars.
Content he's putting out there, he's always going to have fucking
and
bars.
And that's what he's saying, even though, I think that's literally was a line. Something like, if I have, even though I have the bars, even though I'm lyrical, blah, 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 these motherfuckers still hate me or some shit. Man, I thought he was off that vibe.
Yeah.
But I guess he's still off on that vibe. He might be on that vibe last week because he's talking about coronavirus. So these are new verses. These are new lines.
Nah, coronavirus has been happening for a while.
Listen, we never know.
We don't know how long this shit's been going on.
He might have started last week.
No, I like the flow. I like everything, but I just, you know what I'm saying? Is it something I'm going to, so far, is it something I'm going to repeat?
No.
Am I going to want to repeat this in my room or in my car or whatever? You know what I'm saying? That's really what goes through my mind a lot of times. But let's continue.
Yeah, I guess this is just for his diehard stands. That's all it can be. That's all it can be, nigga.
Like it depends, like adult diapers for men. Even when I'm rapping less stellar, it's sour grapes, I still wine, I'm the best seller. Like it- Wait, why the beat cut off? Fuck it. Yeah.
Man. Let's keep it going.
Yeah, let's just keep it going.
Because this is
guys.
Just gonna be, it's gonna be what it is.
I'm sorry. Huh? What? I have an ear infection and I can't finger it out. Oh, yeah, it's my fault. To ego's fault. He's evil.
You know, that's a metaphor for the fans who really think this is like his best shit. Like, if you laughed at that shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, you are one of those people who think this is wow. This is incredible.
This is wild. This, I get it. Like, he's being thematic. He's being funny. But, man, it's like right now in your career, that's what people are getting. You know, I think people, if you're just an overall music fan, you're not going to expect that right now. Oh, Eminem has new music? Oh, maybe he's, like, grown up. Man, he's talking about some different shit. Maybe more personal, blah, blah, blah.
How's Haley doing?
Yeah, like, shit like that. But what he's doing is just really, he might sprinkle that in here, there, and here.
But like at three bars.
But like that's it. Like he doesn't make the full content about that, you know. And he just makes it fun. It's just exercise. Yeah. He's like Lil Wayne. Lil Wayne does that too, you know. But I think Lil Wayne still appeals more than Eminem because Lil Wayne will still have random features and this and that. Like he's on What's Poppin' Remix, one of the biggest remix of the year. Like he always has some sort
of
relevancy.
And he's still doing his own thing.
Yeah, but Eminem, he always fails to do so. I don't mind. Keep dropping music. We're going to have fun regardless. So dark, so keep dropping.
Yes, that's what the Molly and X do. That's who the fucking Molly and X do. But ever since D-Nice to the rescue, stuck inside of a Mario Kart race, stuck in saw blades, at a stop and a start pace. What I'm trying to say is I'm driving them all crazy. I think this way I prefer to stay untuned if I
you know what it is? It's almost like he has to make music, like, just for films and TV and shit now at this point. Because it's
he has to do something else.
I'm sorry, bro. I'm not going to play that.
He has to do something else.
Like, I would never play that song again in my life. And I don't want to be like that guy. That song just shits on this.
Man.
But I would never play that song in my car, in my room, nowhere, ever in my life. This will
never
be the last time in my life.
That we play, that we hear this. Hear those words.
And I don't.
It's tough to listen to this shit.
I don't smile, I don't frown. Get you up or get you down. I was here.
Shout out to DJ Premier. You came in with Book of Rhymes.
I'm emptying. My book of rhymes. So like my balls, I'm in my bag. Get a little testy when I'm mad.
Get a little testy when I'm mad, cause like testicles. I get the damn bar. But,
it's funny and
but
it's
what
good.
What do people want people to do though? Like, ain't nobody gonna be saying that bar like that. It's such a wild, like, ooh.
And that's not only that, he says wild shit. That's cool. That's Eminem, right? But it's like, okay, you got great bars, but can you make like a song that makes us feel the way your individual bars make us feel?
He had that one song about gun control on the on side A of the album. We love that song. And the video was amazing. I think it's really underrated. People really didn't even highlight that shit. It's just frustrating.
It's like, this is crazy. I don't care, it's music to be murdered by. So run a van, can swallow a fucking gyro, bobblehead, and that's slow like all time. And biblical shit's finna hit the fan. Anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then the amygdala hippocampus spill inside the car at the wheel inside a carnival. Cause I'm plowing into every one of those snotty articles. And that explains why the fuck you clowns are all in my grill. Take us out,
so that's why Eminem, that's why Nas popped up as credits, because he sampled Nas, DJ Premier. Okay, that was,
DJ
I would say,
Premier, fantastic.
Fantastic production, probably the, I would say the best song so far for me.
That 3 minute in, that shit was hard.
Yeah.
That shit was hard.
I like that song, it's the best one so far. He flowed differently, he was way more, you know, I feel like aggressive even in his tone compared to other records. I like that. So, but maybe he's setting up for future projects. Who knows? I think there is the potential. If he keeps dropping music, there's a potential for some classic shit to come.
No, 100%.
Eventually. Because you throw so much shit at the wall, something's bound to stick. Look at this. Favorite bitch with Ty Dolla $ign. So music is a bitch. So he's making the music a girl, I guess.
But I forgot about now I got money falling out. 50s, 100s, and 20s. And I know nothing is funny. So repugnant and ugly. I could give the bus the marathon a run for its money. Yeah. And you could say I'm a little bit immature.
I can give the bus the marathon a run for its money.
That's gonna be a CNN.
Body bag, what you did, I need a new chip. Like the music, I had to balance on my favorite. Always hated my smile. She never sugarcoated it to me. She said if I wasn't so stupid and ugly, I wouldn't always get bullied.
That nigga might have to go a cappella with that shit.
Oh my God.
To niggas to feel it.
Oh,
his mom used
God.
To call him ugly and shit and like make him insecure. He's obviously not lying, because Eminem wouldn't just say some shit about that two person
no,
lie.
He went through a lot with his mom, bro.
We understand that story. You know, we saw 8 Mile, even though, no, you know, we saw it, but it has nothing to do with this. But, man, wow, favorite bitch, music was your favorite bitch, and we saw people run through it, blah, 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 blah. I get it. You know, I like the concept of the song. Not too fond of the hook.
Oh,
you
no,
know,
that hook is trash.
I love Ty Dolla $ign, but Ty Dolla $ign is always hit or miss. But when it hits, it hits. He's
yeah.
really magnificent,
yeah.
let's be very honest.
Yeah.
He writes amazingly, but this one's a miss. I'm not gonna lie.
Lyrically insane, and although most are never gonna hit the level Cole or Weezy at, or be emotionally attached.
Okay, right there, let's highlight that line. He did say and acknowledge Lil Wayne.
Lil Wayne and Cole.
Yeah, he said something.
Fire.
He said, what did he say that? He's talked about older rappers.
He said he was acknowledging older ones. There's some of them are lyrically insane.
But they'll never reach the lyrical capacity of Wayne.
Yeah.
But he did say recently in an interview to Lil Wayne that a recent Lil Wayne verse was one of the best verses he heard of all
yeah.
time. He always shows love to Lil
That's
Wayne.
That's dope. That's super dope.
What I want to see is you and Lil Wayne do music. I think that would be doper, you know, than just saying it on a song. But you're going to do what you're going to do. Cause that'll be fire, man. They're both fucking older veterans, still dropping music. Lil Wayne just dropped last week. I think he dropped this week again. Side B on that piff to his mixtape, but only side B. You know, same as this nigga with the side B. Moving on, Guns Blazing with arguably, if not the best producer of all time, Dr. Dre. Every time they collaborate, has been very classic and historic, featuring Sly Piper.
You did it to yourself. Now you got a soul for the consequences.
Dr. Dre might have the verse of the year.
For the fences, dead ass.
Damn.
I'm out hot club till I jet lag.
This nigga's out the divorce, talking crazy.
Double standards of hypocrisy. And that fake hand holding on Father's Day. You a different motherfucker when you're not with me. It's like I'm John F. Kennedy. Shot at me. Yes, I'm president of the blood around. Just don't forget who you fucking with when stepping on hollow ground. Cause you did this to me.
One day and you'll be serving me hot fries.
Dr. Dre, I love Dr. Dre. His verse, very nice. Eminem talking about, I don't know if it was someone for real in real life. It sounded like it because that shit sounded like he really wanted to.
That shit was a film.
Kill someone or at least injure their family.
At least have them serve the French fries at Popeyes.
That shit really got personal there. That was an interesting track. I like that one. I'm not gonna lie.
That was dope.
We're gonna get into the next one, but this next one actually has a music video out with Cole Bennett or directed by Cole Bennett. This is their second music video, I believe. First one was Monster with Juice WRLD. We saw that one. You guys saw a reaction. So this is gonna be the second Eminem and Cole Bennett collaboration. This one's called Nats. I've always been familiar with that word. I really don't remember it being spelled that way. I guess that's how you spell it. I guess it makes sense. Yeah. Nat, like the G is silent. Let's watch this shit together. Oh, ramen noodles.
Still stacking my chips, hoes. Higher than Shaq on his tiptoes. Ain't nothing you say could ever trump. Mike Pence will get killed. If you're hypersensitive, I wasn't referencing the vice president. Chill. Not similar to Mike Vick at all. Cause even if I don't have a dog in the fight, they ain't never gonna get rid of the fight in the dog.
This thing had a Mike Vick jersey playing with dogs. Mike Vick fucking got,
That's dope.
Was he killed dogs and shit? He got arrested because he killed dogs? Yeah. Or he hurt a dog?
Nah, he had them fight each other.
Oh my god. This nigga really is on that Eminem shit.
Yeah. Wow. That line with the Mike and the pen? Mike Pence?
Mike Pence. And Mike Pence and then the Trump dope. Political
that's
shit. This flow was interesting.
Yeah.
Not gonna play the song again. I'm gonna say that. I'm gonna be honest. I'm not gonna play his record again after this. But the flow is interesting.
It's really dope, man.
Because it's like really melancholical. It's almost like he doesn't want you to play it again. He wants you to listen to him more. He usually kind of overraps. I don't know what's going on with this. I don't know why he did a video to this one.
He's really taking his time with every bar,
this is different.
Bitch, you still on my dick or not? If I suck, your wife is a straw. Drinking the SARS and Corona. Like you took a bite off a
bat. What is this?
Then it goes from Martian to human. Yeah. DA got that dopey sense to me. Be back, get that pine saw and that Ajax. Cause this dry cough, they just keep getting more extreme. Who knows when it's night Maryland like Monroe. I'm so fucking dope, dope. And you're a fiend. And that's the one thing that hasn't changed.
His face looks so young though.
I got that. Yeah. The dark horse, I'm a nightmare. Mom fed me value.
Oh, yeah. Part two.
Thought that's my hair trigger whenever I get an idea. So, now my name rings out like a SpongeBob. Totally inappropriate with an opiate, groping it while I'm holding it like a trophy. I'm hoping a little codeine will give me odium. Topia with the dope, I'm an OG. I'm like the goat here to get your goat. Little bit of sodium. It's a salt when I'm at the podium. It's your throat holy. Come on, like voting, but no clothing. Stripped down to it. I got into a little bit of an argument with her, so I took a little lick of a line up in a dinner. Then I hit it with a motherfucking ottoman and bitter. Then I said, these stars are like COVID.
Wow.
You get them right off the bat.
Okay.
Corona,
nigga eating bats. Oh my lord. Wow, Cole Bennett again, strikes
that
again.
Dope,
Cole
man.
Bennett and DA got that dope. Creative song right there. I like the ending way more than the beginning of the song. I like when he switched up the beat there. It seemed like it was more like trumpets or like those type of, you know, instruments going on. I love that. His flow on that sounded better. I was like, wow, it's really interesting. He started spazzing. He really killed that shit at the end. I'm not going to lie. They say these bars are like COVID. You get it straight off the bat. And I get it. You know, off bat. Like, what do niggas say? Like, oh, you got that shit off bat? Like, you get it quick? But he's talking about off bat literally because they say COVID came from bats in Wuhan.
He had a lot of great bars on this song.
I think the song comes off with
the most amount of bars per capita.
It's like Rhode Island with cases and COVID. Where we're from.
I like it. That was nice.
It comes off very theatrical.
Yeah, great.
You know, I think it's just fun. It's fun. Yeah. I don't think it's horrible. I don't think it's. I think he's had way worse music recently. I like it for what it is.
Yeah.
Am I gonna play it again? Maybe not. But I do like it for what it is.
It was fun. I think fun is a great word to describe. It was really fun. It was really dope. It was really entertaining.
Eminem's one of the best, man. Lyrically, you know, Cole Bennett, amazing that he gets to do that again.
Yeah.
At this point, them niggas might have more shit coming. I don't fucking know. They might have mad shit working on.
I don't want to harp on this, but Cole Bennett, congratulations, man. You know what I'm saying? Like, you've made it from the bottom to the top. Sure.
Jesus Christ, 2 Eminem music videos? Are you kidding me? Let alone the first one with Juice WRLD, rest in peace. Like, that's crazy, man. Moving on, comment down below, how do you guys feel about that record, Nat? Do you like it? How do you guys feel about the album? If you're just watching the video reaction, go watch the full album reaction right now, because we're about to continue that ourselves.
Yeah.
Higher.
You know, I've been around for a while now. I'm not sure if I have much left to prove.
You don't! That's the thing!
Yeah.
See, I don't like when he says shit like that.
Shit, man.
Are you fucking dick tickling us? What is this shit? That's the first line of the song, midway through the album. See, I don't know. I've been in this game for so long. I don't know if I have much left to prove. And then he's like laughing. That's what we're saying.
Yeah.
You know, but we get hated on? Not by you, because you might be watching these videos. I feel like he obviously does. He watches
shit. Yeah, he watches
it. It's interesting, man. I don't know, you know, I say it every reaction, man. We would love to sit down with you and talk with you, because your mind, I would just want to understand it. Yeah. But I think no one can.
I've done it all, man. But in actuality, I haven't yet. It's every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Very interesting.
I like the Mike Strange vocals. Again, I do like, you know, that's the thing about Eminem. It's like you said earlier. He should do movies. He should do a lot of other things because I think I think he's so amazing when it comes to, like themes and like
his
writing.
His concepts are incredible.
Because that concept of the song is pretty dope. Like, it's like an artist looking back, like, damn, I've done enough. But it's like when I keep going and keep making music and keep working, it's like I go higher than I've ever been. So he feels more confident.
Yeah.
You know? And that's interesting. That's interesting.
That's great. And we're not questioning your capacity to go further.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Jay-Z supposedly recently said that, according to Rory on the podcast. He was like, Jay-Z told him, like, jokingly, like, I'm getting better. Like, he whispered to him, I'm getting better. So if, like, these artists, they feel that way, it's scary, but it's also like, according to who are you getting better?
Yeah, that's
to yourself?
Thing. Prior to their own idea of what they were in the past and what they where they needed to be.
Because the world's not saying that. The world's not saying Eminem's getting better.
Because the reality is he comes from a different era. And if you're going with the standards of that era, the bars and the beats and the heartbeat, he's probably getting better. But if you're going with the standard of right now, of course not, because you're not fitting in. And that's okay. You know what I'm saying? But that's just the reality. When I listened to this song, all I can think about was, wow, this guy has a great capacity, and it's also because of who he is, the money he has received, and the accolades and his respect, that he's able to put his ideas precisely as they are from his head onto paper and onto tracks.
This one right here is featuring Maj. I saw Maj on Twitter. He was celebrating this feature. He's not that well known, and he was excited. He was like, oh, this is dope. You know, Eminem reached out.
I love what Eminem does that.
He does that,
With Jesse
Reyes. Every so often.
Really dope.
Like, unknown artists, he taps into them early on into their careers.
Hate it no matter what it is, yet you still click on it. Yeah, I want you to change, but don't change. I want you to grow, but don't age. I want the new, but don't shady. I want you to say what they won't say.
He explained it perfectly. And that's been our conflict, where it's like, I don't want him to go back to his old music, but I don't want him to go, you know what I'm saying? Like,
no, he watches the videos. That's what it is.
He
watches the videos.
Those haters who are going to hate regardless, you know what I'm saying? Like that's why we are who we are, because we're trying to go into it with a positive feeling. Okay, this man is going to really do this, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
He's going to prove himself, but then he doesn't have to prove himself. But it's just that we're conflicted at this point, because we want to love it. We want to love everything you do, man, because you were so, so important to us in our development as a youth.
And at the end of the day, the
reality is, you know what I'm saying?
He says the shit he says, but we can say the same shit back. You know, he says, like, you guys want me to this? You want me to do that? You want me to do that? The haters? But you guys still click. Yeah, but you still keep addressing the haters every single song and every single fucking album. And it's not, like, he hasn't missed yet. Every interview, it's like, this has been, like, what? Like, a good 5-6 years? Like, this whole, like, you care about our opinion. You know, so if you really didn't care, you really would address it. You know, and like we're saying, we do care and we do share our opinion, even if we don't like the music, because you're Eminem. We respect you so much and we want to like the music, because who knows? Like I said earlier, you might fucking get a drop of classic again. Like, you have the potential to do anything because you're Eminem. We're not Eminem. We ain't shit compared to you. You know, I think that's obvious. But You do care about our opinion.
As a human, I am. Fuck that.
Yeah.
Black people dying, they want equal rights. White people want to get haircuts. Some people protest, some people riot. But we ain't never escaping this virus. Ooh, I say a line. People are outraged. The press slams me again. People ain't having it nowadays.
I love the talk about Black Lives Matter movement and that talk about white people want to get haircuts. Ooh.
Eminem has always been on the right side of politics, on the right side of history. When it comes to
right, we mean correct.
Correct. Yeah, not the right Republican side. Eminem rapping again. He says he's not going anywhere, so we're gonna keep listening to the music.
Is that a key in my pocket, or am I just happy to see? Cause I am the cause. The cause meaning cousin. Chicks is all the thing getteth.
We got Bobby Lee on the track.
Chicks. Bro, I don't know what's going on.
Bobby Lee on the beat.
I don't know what the fuck that was.
It's dope. He's having fun. Fuck it.
Fuck.
She loves me.
She loves me not for who I am, but what I got. But she loves me. She loves me not.
It's a
loves
move.
Me.
It's a
she
move.
Loves me not.
It's a move.
She
loves
like a soundtrack song.
Noodling, I'm not in the mood for. Gotta get me out of these drawers if you want a spoon, dog. But before we get the drop in these drawers, design.
Soundtrack vibes.
The man drops movies, man. This shit is for movies, dog.
Yeah, it really sounds literally like a soundtrack. That's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
Moving on, Killer.
15, 20, 25, 30. Yeah, get the money. Throw it in the furnace. Yeah, this shit be funny.
Yeah, got that dope.
Call it toilet paper.
That's crazy.
For cash. Bag, call
it sounds like a tiger beat.
In duffel bags, but some pump the
Eminem flow got different.
She picked her up. She yelled out, it's a birthday. She's 50 and in the club.
That's
she's
good. A buzz, huh? That was hard. That was fun.
I'll tell you this much. If I see a song named Eminem Killer, I'm not going to expect it to sound like that. Maybe that's on purpose. You know, obviously, D8 got that dope. Very more upbeat
dope.
Tempo beats, like club vibes. He doesn't care what we say, so let's keep going. Zeus, almost ending the album. This is featuring White Gold. Never heard of him.
Takashi, bitch, you lost me. Yeah, fair with the wishy washy.
Talking to Takashi?
She says I am trash, but she listens to Takashi. Bitch, you lost me.
Yeah, fair with the wishy washy.
But she listens to Takashi.
She says I am trash.
Okay, he's not talking about us at least, because we do not listen to that motherfucker either.
We promise to be honest and wholeheartedly. Apologies, we honor for that song that leaked. I'm sorry, Bri. It wasn't meant to cause you grief. Regardless, it was wrong of me.
Yeah, first time I said sorry.
Clouds like Zeus when they say you ain't.
No. They did it to Chance Dexter to be mentioned in future in the past tense. For saying adios to Migos. I ain't dissing, I'm just trying to keep the shit a C note. Been trying to do the shit to me, so I call them people because they're so easy to see through them. First thing I need is Snoop dogging me. Man, dog, you was like a damn god to me. Not really. I had dog backwards.
Head up in the clouds like Zeus when they say you ain't the goat. I come down like
so, very interesting song, Zeus. First of all, I would not expect that the song named Zeus featuring a feature that we haven't heard yet would be the one where, you know, first of all, people are not going to automatically click on it, but it's the one where he addresses a lot of important shit.
Yeah.
But that's Eminem for you. He's really surprised out the bag, out of nowhere. So he addresses here the Rihanna song, which leaked. Where
I'm not playing Rihanna, where'd you get the BD yet? Let me get my 2 cents. Of course I side with Chris Brown. I beat a bitch down too if she gave my dick an itch now.
He apologizes for that. Which he really does. He doesn't give a fuck about apologizing. Then he addressed a Chance the Rapper falling off.
And he's like,
he relates to that.
The same thing with Future and make him past tense.
Yeah, he's saying in the future they're gonna do it
and
to
the
Future past tense because it's a play on the word future. Yeah. I don't think they will do that with Future, but we can keep. We're gonna be here still alive with you, Eminem, hopefully. So we're gonna witness that if it does happen. Then he says with the Migos, it did happen with the Migos, I would say. But I do think that the Migos still have a chance to come back. I think
the
Migos really haven't just dropped music. Yeah.
Chance does too.
Yeah, I think the Migos really just haven't dropped music. I don't think they're comparable, their situations is what I'm trying to get at. But I get him trying to see that because they are peers. They are in the music industry. But I don't think that Eminem falling off has anything to do with
perceived fall off.
Yeah, it's not near or close to the Migos or Chance the Rapper. You're old. You know, I think that goes, you're a veteran, you got the respect. I think Chance might still not have that respect. I think he still has a lot of work to do.
He has a lot of work to do.
I think Migos gets the respect due to the sound that they cultivated and created.
Mm-hmm.
But still, a lot of people are still critical of them. And then Snoop Dogg said, "I used to be the dog to me," but he meant backwards. "Used to look to you as a god." But wasn't Eminem at Snoop Dogg's Hall of Fame or Walk of Fame thing recently? It was Snoop Dogg. It was Eminem and Dr. Dre.
I never knew they had problems. I saw that a long time ago.
Yeah, that Snoop Dogg then says that Eminem's not top five rapper of all time.
Top 10.
People, yeah, top 10.
Put Eminem in a position where he could be labeled as one of the top 10 rappers ever. I don't think so, but the game feels like he's top 10.
Even kind of worse. I mean, people kind of shocked because obviously their ties, Dr. Dre, you know, and Eminem just being Eminem. You know, Eminem was taken back by that. Yeah, it used to be a god to me. Man, I don't know, man. Eminem really cares about what people think about him no matter what. No matter if you're us or Snoop Dogg, and it will always be that way. And he's always going to put it on record.
And he's always, like, knows what's going on in the culture.
Yeah.
For him to say that Chance shit?
Yo. That's some, like, even the Migos shit, because the Chance shit is, like, very more apparent. But the Migos really haven't been literally, like, canceled or, like,
and
trending.
And the Future shit, too? Like, you don't put Future past tense? That's a great line to think of. Because, like,
he knows how good Future is. Yeah. That's what it fucking really is. Future's the fucking shit,
Future
nigga.
Future came back with that last project.
Yo,
holy
Future's
shit.
The shit. Especially this year. His
that's
features.
The thing. You get one album... You come back hard.
Man.
Future did. He was falling off. It's true.
Yeah, he was. He had the moments with the Juice WRLD album.
Yeah, it was bad.
But he picked it right back up, man. He gave us content to break down and talk about.
I should mention that we have decided that...
Last song, discombobulated.
I'm discombobulated.
Body St. Andrew's Hall, too many times to count. Before I tear up the shelter, give my dogs a pound. Now I'm about to treat all of you got what I'm talking about. Fuck, I'm discombobulated.
Now up is down.
Fuck it, I'm a kook. I know I got a screw and a couple of marbles loose. My back to Niagara, no life jacket, man tired. Like six psychiatrists, scientists,
Mr. Diagnosed
me with plaque psoriasis. Cause I asked them, why is it my
Emma and then discombobulated. Ending side B right there. I like that. Classic Eminem flow, classic Eminem production.
Yeah.
Three beats in one. He's done that before, obviously. Very similar to the Andre Young, the Dr. Dre production he's had in the past. I like that, man. Man, I would say that might be my favorite. Is that my favorite song off this side B? Probably. I would say, well, I did like the Zeus song, I'm not gonna lie. Even though he addressed shit, aside from that, I liked it as a song.
Yeah.
But, man, overall, side B.
Zeus, yeah.
Yeah, Zeus.
White gold?
White gold on it. But overall, man, I don't know. It's interesting to see.
You know what really gave me, like a really great perspective? It's the video with
Cole Bennett.
It really allowed me to see, man, this is fun for him still.
Yeah.
And I love that. And why can't I just say, okay, he's just having fun?
Yeah.
Let me just take it like he's just having fun. This is a man who cemented himself in the history books of hip hop.
Yeah.
He's just having fun at this point. And if he's able to say that, I wish he can just say that. Guys, please understand I'm just having fun. We can have fun with you.
Yeah.
We don't have to hold you to this, oh my god, he's gonna prove himself like he did in the past.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said, do you have something to prove still? You do. That's why sometimes I get conflicted because I'm like, I'm trying to, okay, what's the thing he's trying to prove? What's that amazing thing he's going to do next? I'm waiting for it. But if you're just having fun, I think maybe you have to just go back to having fun because that video looked fun and looked like you were just having fun. It was a lot of fucking fun.
Because we'd rather have him having fun than being depressed and sad and on some dark shit. Eminem going through it.
We're talking about somebody
we want him alive.
To.
Yeah, it's a lot of careers, man, and just entertainment in general. It's similar to, like, even the Kevin Hart situation where Kevin Hart had a lot of classic moments and one of the best of all time. So to this day, some people might say he's the funniest of all time. To this day, people might say Eminem's the best rapper of all time.
But the reality is what?
You got, this shit is not up to the time right now. We got younger people coming in. It's a new era. It's a new time.
And you can continue to hit. Like, I watched...
Chris Tucker?
I watched his stand-up, bro. Yeah. He did a couple years ago, and I was like, wow, this shit is good.
That was a good one.
Damn!
That was a good one.
You can still hit. Don't get me wrong. Jay-Z's still hitting. Lil Wayne's still hitting. We got the classic still hitting.
Yeah.
We got Dipset going hard.
Yeah, still spinning like they're 12 again.
You know what I'm saying? But... Kevin Hart's last special was trash.
Yeah.
And we're gonna hold you to that last special.
I'm in a position to talk to these kids and they listen. I ain't no politician, but I kick it with them a minute.